Hi students and welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. So today I'm going to discuss about the SBI clerk prelim strategy. So very important strategy that I'm going to discuss with you according to the 2018 exam, right? So students, I am also conducting the regular SBI clerk 2018 classes on bankexamstudy's mobile application. Free notes are available on bankexamstudy.com for SBI clerk 2018 exam. So install the bank exam for this Android application for sure. Okay, so this is the exam pattern of pre exam. This is the exam pattern of SBI clerk pre, right? There is sectional timing of 20 minutes each for English, reasoning and quantitative ability or the numerical ability. What people used to do is people used to just devote like this 23 to 25 minutes here, then 23 to 25 minutes to reasoning, and then 15 minutes to English. But that's not going to work now because there is sectional timing. So students, what you should do? So for quantitative aptitude students, just divide the whole syllabus into two parts, right? For example, there are approximation, simplification, quadratic equation, number series. In these topics, in these chapters, it is actually very, I won't say easy, but it takes less time. While in DI, there are sets of five questions or seven, six questions. There are sets of five questions, right? So sometime what happens, suppose you start with one data interpretation set, and if you are not able to solve this data interpretation set within 10 minutes, there will be very low probability that you will actually crack the exam. So what is the solution? Divide the whole, you know, section into two parts, the first and second. In the first part, in the first round, we call it first round. In the first round, there are chapters like approximation, quadratic equation, simplification, number series, time and work, time and distance, problems based on ages, ratio and analysis, percentages. So these are the part of the first round. It is up to you. While you are doing your practice, while you are taking the mock test, you need to decide that whether you want to do these, the first round first or the second round first, right? This is the first round: quadratic equation, approximation, number series, time and work, time and distance, averages. These questions, you will find at least 20 to 25 questions from these topics and remaining 15 questions from data interpretation. So it is up to you. Give like 12-13 minutes to the round one and let's say 7 to 8 minutes to round 2. In the round 2, there is data interpretation and data sufficiency. Most of the time you will find the data interpretation or the lengthy question in which there are sets of 5 questions. So in these 12 to 13 minutes, you can, if you have done proper practice, you in this 12 to 13 minutes, let's say 12 minutes, you can easily do 15-16 questions if you have done proper practice. And the remaining 8 minutes, it is up to you. In the remaining 8 minutes, you can do, let's say, one or two sets, right? So it is up to you whether you want to do these 20 questions within 12 minutes. But see student, even from these 20 questions, if you are facing any problem in any question, just skip it. Skip that question. Then there are just 15 to 16 questions left that you need to do within 12 minutes. You need to pick the easy question and forget about the difficult ones. Any question that you feel is difficult, forget about it. And then the 8 minutes, give it to data interpretation. I think you can do just one or one and a half sets. In the second set, if possible, you can do 2 or 3 questions. So 5 to 7 questions here, or let's say you can even do like, it is up to you. So divide the quantitative aptitude, reasoning and even the English section into parts, into 2 rounds. You are going to attempt your paper in rounds. Round 1 The simple things, the simple chapters, quadratic approximation, number series, time and work, time and distance, round two, data interpretation, right? Or the topics that you feel that are actually difficult for you, you need to divide it into rounds. Again, the same fund applies here. The round one is coding, decoding, syllogism, direction sense test, blood relation questions. This is the round one, or inequality is the easiest part of the reasoning section. If somebody asks me what is the easiest part of the reasoning section, the first one is inequalities and second one is syllogism and direction sense or blood relation. These are the easiest part of the reasoning section. So round one, give it like 12-13 minutes, right? Maybe possible that you'll be able to attempt like 16 to 20 questions, right? Or maybe more than that, it is up to you. And then round two. Round two is puzzles and seating arrangements. So never attempt the puzzles at the beginning. Always attempt the puzzles and data interpretation sets in round two. So round two is puzzles. Give it like 8 minutes. Select between puzzles or seating arrangement, just give it a look, right? Just find, there will be I think 3 sets, 2 puzzles or 1 seating arrangement. You need to make a selection. So which puzzle to do first or which seating arrangement to do first, right? So select one. In case you are able to solve that within like 8 minutes, suppose you solve that within 5 to 6 minutes, 1 or 2 minutes are left, go back there. Go back there. Don't try to attempt another set here. Go back there. There might be a possibility that you attempted, let's say, like 17 to 18 question or 18 to 19 question from this part. Say 6-7 question might be there which are unattempted. You need to go back and just give like 2 minutes. There is a possibility that you will fetch 1 or 2 marks again here. So even 1 or 2 minutes are very important. 1-2 minutes in quant, 1-2 minutes in reasoning, and again 1 or 2 minutes in English. Very important, right? So divide the whole syllabus into rounds. Round one, round two. For each of that sections, again in English, round one, round two. Round one is the grammar based questions. So if you are good in grammar, if you are good enough in grammar, then the grammar related questions like error detection, close test, fill ups. So if you are good at grammar, then this is your round one. If you are not good at grammar, then the comprehension and jumbled paragraphs are your round one. So if you are good at grammar, the error detection, close test and fill-ups, they are very easy for you, very scoring for you. This is round one for you and this is round two for you. So that's how you need to attempt the paper. The notes, students, the notes for SBI clerk is available on bankexamstudy.com. We are running the regular classes for SBI clerk. I request you to install bank exams today mobile app. I don't know why I am promoting my application again and again. Bank exams today's mobile app is available, right? On Android, right? Please install our mobile application. Even I am conducting daily classes for SBI clerk and I am providing daily mock tests and providing the notes for SBI clerk. Please go to bankexamstoday.com or please go to Bank Exams Today's mobile app, install it, and please take the SBI clerk course. In case you have any other doubt, students, you can call me, right? You can call me 906720100. That's my number. I request all of you to subscribe. Very important, students, for me, subscribe to this channel if you want more suggestions, more tips like these, right? So that's all for today, students. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye bye.